can't we see this video? Sure. Yes.
Hello, dear learners. Hello, friends. How are you?
Hello, everyone.
So, Team AW is here with you. Myself, Dr. Ajay Semalti, Dr. Okay. Mona, and Lokesh.
Hello. Hello, everybody.
So, Lokesh Adhikari with us, as usual. So, today, in this huge rainy day, it's raining very heavy since last night, I think in across the country. So, we were worried about the connectivity. Anyhow, we are lucky enough to have the connectivity at this moment. Otherwise, it won't have been possible to conduct the webinar. So, thanks to God Almighty. Okay. So, we'd like to open up the discussion.
First question we received is something on about how to create or make an author profile public.
Yeah. For making the author profile public in Scholar, in Google Scholar, you are talking about the Scholar only. Okay. So, what you can do that you have to verify the email, institutional email you will have to. I think if you are having the institutional email ID, then only then, when it is verified, you will enter that institutional email ID, that link will be given there, it will be activated, then only the profile will be public. However, after that also, you have the, you can say the permission, you either allow to be public or not, it's on you. But the step is you have to verify the email. Okay, isn't it?
Yes, it's the case. First you have to get an institutional or official email ID, and then you can link your Scholar profile or any other profile link with that email ID, and then you can have your profile publicly open. Okay. One thing I like to request you all the participants that please directly come to the question you are going to ask. Skip the good afternoon or hello everyone, like these things, and just come to the questions.
Directly let us come to the point. I was seeing a question, sorry I forgot to mention that, to note down the name, but why all the journals are not having the impact factor? Because all journals are not in the indexing services. All journals are not covered by the indexing services, which are responsible for giving the impact factor. Okay. And very first condition is to be online. For having an impact factor, for very first condition is the journal must be online. Any of its version, at least abstract must be online. Okay. It may not be completely online. Secondly, it should be cited, it should be indexed by the reputed indexing agencies. Then, when the indexing services count their number of publications, number of citations, then they provide the impact factor if they qualify for that, the definition of impact factor. Okay, so that's why many of the journals which are very old, rather in arts and humanities, it's a problem many times. I think not in sciences, but arts and humanities, many journals are offline only. So that's why they can't, even though they are prestigious, they are from very good organization, they are not having the impact factor. This is a problem. They have to come to the online platform, then only then their tracking will be towards with the indexing agency, and then the impact factor will be given.
Another thing I would like to address is our internet speed is very, very low. So please have patience, and you can also watch this stream afterwards, after completion of this stream, as a full video on YouTube. If you miss anything, please go through the video afterwards. The next question, sir, was about the CARE journal. Many of our participants wants to know about the concept of CARE and which type of journals are included.
What happened that it was a discussion in the last decade about the UGC. In Indian perspective, UGC started approving the journals as to avoid the predatory journal. What happened in this scenario, because the system was not ready enough, so many tedious journals, as we have mentioned, Tom, Dick and Harry journals, were in the list of the approved journals. So institutes, professors, scientists, raised their objection. Then what happened? Even in 2012, I wrote to UGC regarding this thing also, that in sciences, you go with the Scopus and Web of Science indexing. Forget about anything else, okay? Then whatever the, if it is indexed in the Scopus or Web of Science in sciences, go by that. Or for arts and humanities, you make a provision of some kind of provision so that the list can be prepared for approved journals. So, I was happy to see the UGC notification last year that yes, it has been adopted now that only in science cases, the journals which are indexed in Scopus and Web of Science will be taken automatically, okay? If you have published in a journal which is Scopus or Web of Science indexed, don't worry about that. It is 100% UGC approved journal, okay, in sciences. Even in arts and humanities, if it is indexed in Scopus and Web of Science, forget about anything. If not, the CARE, a committee has been prepared by UGC under the leadership of renowned professors who have prepared the list of the journals which satisfy the approved journal status. And they have given the list. I think it's available in the UGC website now. And it is a dynamic list. It is adding on, and sometimes if the objection is there, it is being removed. The journals are being removed also. So it's a dynamic list. So you must be in touch with the UGC. And I always recommend to go by the Scopus and Web of Science journals. Yes, okay? Yes. Simply, it is the best thing.
So another question.
SCI and non-SCI. Difference between SCI and non-SCI.
Yes. SCI is index.
By Anuradha.
Anuradha. It's a science citation index. Science SCI index. The Scopus, SCI, Web of Science. These are the indexing services. Okay, SCI is rather the one of the largest indexing services. SCI, and I would like to ESCI, Expanded Science Citation Index. If a journal is there in SCI, Scopus, Web of Science, and ESCI, it means they are the good journals. Simply, as a thumb rule. And if not, then it requires approval or some kind of recommendation from committees like CARE and other kinds. Okay.
Another question is, interesting question is by USA. Why do we need many metrics like impact factor, site score, etc.? Can't we maintain a single one? It's a good question.
Good question. What happens, boss? There is no single player in this domain.
Yes.
That is the basic thing.
Yes.
You are having a lot many television. Why not a single brand?
Yes.
There are so many publishers. There are so many indexing agencies. And to give the maximum benefit, it is better that there must not be any monopoly. Even it might be possible if there is only one agency and that too it is a private agency. It may have bias towards its own journals, and it's happening.
Yes, in other cases, we can explain by this this phenomena with the consideration of the subject or streams. Some authorities only works with the science, like Web of Science started their work with science stream or medicine, like PubMed. It works specifically, or it's most of its work is dedicated to the medicine and the related subjects. But what about the social sciences? Authority is also needed for that purpose also. So with the change of stream, there are requirements for the different authorities to consider the quality of journals. Okay?
Good boss. Tamil Sarkar, he was asking that DUI, Digital yes. Object DUI. Identification. Okay, DUI is not a big thing, boss. So don't have in your mind that if a journal is having a DUI, it's a very good journal. Even you can start your own journal and start.
And DUI is not given to a particular journal. It's given to a particular article. Why? It's like a barcode for a particular object. So in case of digital information, we give DUI. published.
It's just like a URL. Yes. You can say it's a URL for your article.
URL in case of websites and barcodes for the products.
Please remove from your mind that having a DOI in a particular journalism means it's a very good journal. No. Sorry to say.
What will be considered as best SJR?
Best SJR. You know, SJR range from, it's a very heavy range. To be very honest, I haven't gone through the range of SJR because I'm dealing with my own subjects only in the research. When I'm talking about the research, so I'm dealing with the SJRs in my field only. In our field, in pharmaceutical sciences and the applied sciences, these SJRs and impact factor are very less, you know. Even the best journals of our field are having the impact factor of 5, 6, not more than that. Okay, it starts from 0.5. Even if you have published in the 2 impact factor, 2.5 impact factor, you are very good. Okay, it is a quartile based. I was discussing with Lokesh. That is a web of science. We have not elaborated this thing very much. You can go through the web of sciences. They have prepared some classes of journals.
Yes.
Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4 journals. Okay, depending on the importance. If a journal, if a science personnel have published, I'm from pharmaceutical sciences, I have published an impact factor 5. And if a arts and humanity people have published an impact factor 0.5, it doesn't mean that importance of that person, that publication is less because it has just published in 0.5. Basically, the journal, where the journal is lying, whether it is in Q1, Q2, Q3 or Q4, you are publishing in the lower quartile. And even if you are publishing in the impact factor 4, doesn't mean. If you are publishing in the high impact quartiles, then your weight will be more, even though you are publishing in the lower impact factor. So it's about the specialization or subject coverage of a journal. Okay?
What about previously published journal status? Are they going to be considered? I think it's related to the care list.
Hmm.
If anyone's journal is published already in care,
what you have to
not be.
No, for, it will be considered if it is published before the list came out.
Sorry, I would like to rectify this thing.
There. For it will be counted in for CAS.
For CAS, it will be counted, but you will have to give your for direct recruitment. It is not being considered. You have published the thing for direct recruitment, they will consider only the publication, not the date of it. It is considered only for CS. That the date for that particular date. At that particular date it was valid. It was approved.
Yes.
So it will be considered approved, but not for direct recruitment.
Okay, there is one question. Can the publisher of a journal be money motive or publish for cash as it happens in majority of the cases? What feedback mechanism is
in this case we have two factors, one money and one quality. Okay? Money motivation, yes, it is there. Quality, it is there. And in case of established publishers, money and quality, both the factors matters equally. It's not just about the money, it's not just about the quality. They have to maintain the quality, so for that purpose they need money. And where they will get it? From the authors. Okay, or the readers. They will try to have a good balance between the money and the quality, and this will be considered in India also. Okay.
Welcome, Tony. You have raised a very good question. You are regular with us with our webinar. I would like to answer this thing that Google journal is not a particular word. Google is just a database. If whatever you publish, it will be there. Okay. So, and whatever the journal is claiming, you can't rely on that thing only. If a journal is saying that I'm a Scopus index, I'm having this much impact factor, don't rely on this thing. Go to these indexing services and search that whether it is indexed or not. That's why the predatory journal claims, because they know that you are not going to do this thing. That's why no journal can give you the acceptance in half an hour or two days. No journal, sorry, if it is a genuine journal. Okay? So always remember that. Don't compromise this thing. And money is always a factor. You know, even the reputed publishers need the money, but they get the money, they earn the money from subscriptions, not from the article processing charges. Even the very good journals are going for open access policy. if you want to have your paper published in open access, they charge from you. Okay, it's a very good amount, very good amount. Even the NIH funding by the US give the special permission for open access publishing. It is around $600, $700, $800 for impact factor journals.
In they most of the countries, in the subscription most journal, of the developed they countries, they have this provision that their university either funds them or in another way, they get some waiver of for the goods impact factor journals. The next question is, RG score given by ResearchGate is having any value equivalent to the H-index?
Sorry. RG score, you please don't ever see the RG score. I don't rely on that thing.
Specifically ask for the CS promotion.
No. RG score, not at all, boss. Yes. RG score is not at all. RG score is just as Facebook. You know, even if you are, you can have a good RG score if you are discussing many things. It's simple thing. Many times your RG score will be increasing. We have discussed this thing also. Even you can have your own data set, own unpublished data there, and you can discuss them. Your RG score will improve. It is not authentic one. You just can have good idea from the RG score, that a little bit idea you may have, but not concrete idea. You cannot claim with the RG score. However, the score of the Scopus H index, that it may give, it will give you the real picture. Scopus H index, Web of Science H index. You will see the Google Scholar H index. If you want to be happy, see your H index. If you want to be self-critical, go to the Scopus H index. If you want to be the more self-critical, go to the Web of Science H index. You will see the, it will be decreasing from Google Scholar to Scopus to Web of Science.
Yes. Next question is again by Tony. How to check the citation of our published articles? I think first you have to get your article listed in any these type of services like Google Scholar or which provides the citation details. Then you can check easily if your paper is enlisted in the Google Scholar database or their repository. Then you can have your citation details very easily. Okay. The next question is, how to know the best journal metrics between the various types? The best one is Thomson Reuters.
Yeah, by okay. Clarivate. So
these are without any confusion.
Without any.
This is globally accepted and best
and,
so far.
And please don't rely on the impact factor claimed by any journal.
Yes.
Someone
has asked this, Shashi Komar, is the index Copernicus is considered? Similar question is like that. You have answering
now? Index Copernicus, because it has also become a business.
Yes.
It has also become a business indexing to be an indexing agency. Yes. You know, people are having, and the things are going on. So don't go for these things. Go for the reputed indexing agencies, reputed index journals. Okay. Even though I have also discussed in our module that even though if a journal is not having impact factor, if it is having a good indexing agency, go for publication on that particular journal.
And I think site score is still unreliable in some cases in comparison with the Web of Science list or SJR. If a journal is not approved by the CARE, why isn't it curbed by UGC? Because UGC is not a governing body for the publication. If you want to publish, you can publish. But it will not be considered for UGC's procedure of recruitment. Okay. So it is not necessarily to be banned, to ban the publisher or to do some legal actions to the publisher because they are not in the care list. This is not the case. How to publish your paper?
Not many
exercises. Yes, you have to go through the course.
Showing that, but then, I have published 4 papers. What is the question there? But if I have published the 4 papers and that I couldn't see it properly.
I find out that the old 4 papers which were online and the certificate is showing good impact factor are not available now. What was there for 1 year only? Impact factor is for 1 year only.
Boss. Actually, what is happening that impact factor, in the sense you can say impact factor is a dynamic
social
index.
Even some journals
are having good impact factor. Good, it may say a 0.5 impact factor is there. It might be possible next year it won't have the impact factor. So you can't say that. But okay, if it is having the, once it has got the impact factor, it is always the chance that the next year or the next year it will get the get it again. So it's better to go for the best indexing journals.
The next question is, how to publish our article in a good indexing agency? Indexing agencies are very much different from the publishers. Okay, you have to understand the difference between an indexing agency and publisher. Okay,
I request you, don't go by the UGC list. UGC list is a dynamic one. Once I have claimed something, if it is there, it has been recommended by somewhere, if it is recommended by the committee, if I claim with some evidences that this is the predatory journal, it will be removed at all. If the committee is convinced with my facts, it will be removed. It is gonna be removed. So what will happen? So don't rely on these things. Go to the reputed publishers, reputed indexing agencies, and reputed journals. Even if they are not online, go for the reputed one.
Ankur is asking, why do open access journals charge money?
Open access journals. How the open access journal will get the running cost? You know,
they have
cost.
To get through the review process, and they have to get through the publication process.
No, they have to Springer, all Bentham, the Talent Science. They are not charging the anything. How they are getting the money? They are getting the money from their huge amount of subscription.
Yes.
You see the subscription fee, annual subscription fee of those journals. Sometimes $30,000, $40,000, $50,000. They are earning the money. Actually, for running the quality material, quality money is needed.
Someone has to pay for
Has to pay. But these reputed agencies are at least having these expenses from the proper channel.
Yes.
Not from the improper or illegal channels.
Yeah. And in most of the cases, these are minimum.
Vinin Kumari asking, sir, please suggest me some UGC approved journal having impact factor greater than 10. You didn't mention the subject first. You have to mention the subject.
Please specify, yes.
Yeah. You have to go through your things. Best, I suggest you to go to the SCI Index journals, Web of Science journals, Scopus journals, select your subject specific journal and then see the impact factor of that, or you can go to the publisher wise. You go to Elsevier's, you go to the Bentham, see, select the journal list, see the journal list, select your subject specific journals, and see one by one. You can also
in
get
case
things,
of
if you are not having the list.
Social sciences, they can go with the Oxford publications.
No, they can.
Cambridge publications.
Yeah, I'm just saying, don't go by this thing that only 3-4 publishers. There are so many publishers.
Tony
is again asking, as a PhD scholar, can a review article be published based on study theme?
Because the
project
review
committee says it is not considered.
Publication of a review article on the basis of study
subject theme. Ke upar
but it will not be considered as a paper by their project review committee.
Problem is there about the review paper. When it is, in many cases, review papers are not counted. I have discussed this thing in module. It is a paradox regarding the review paper that though review papers are cited a lot, they are very popular. They get the huge readership because they are having the ample of knowledge within a single article. But problem is, it is just a compilation. So the committees generally don't give the weightage. Many times don't give the weightage. However, in case of, it is different. About the approach, if you are preparing an article which is a meta-analysis based review article, it is equivalent to a research article. And what about this non-science people? What they will do? Their most of the work is like review paper.
Yes.
So what will you do? So it's on the basis of subject, on the basis of field of search. On the basis of
one thing I want to inform you, all the participants, most of you are asking about the impact factor journal of your subject. Please go to ResearchGate and search the list JCR, Journal Citation Report 2019. It is available there, downloadable in PDF form, and then search about your subject specific impact factor based journals. Okay, you will get the list. It is not possible for us to share impact factor journals, high impact factor journals for all the subjects. So it's very easy. Just go to the ResearchGate.
As Surbhi asking about the SNP, source normalized impact per paper. We have discussed in the module, I think we have kept it open also, 11.3, yes. I think 11 part 3, it is mentioned there. It is for specifically for those topics in which are not generally the hot topics, but the research done on non-glamorous topics also get the attention with respect to the source normalized impact paper, because those paper had their individual weight. So the source normalized impact per paper is given to the those journals which are publishing this kind of papers. We have given with the example of our हमारा डिस्ट्रिक्ट चमोली और डिस्ट्रिक्ट उत्तराखंड में जो हमने जिक्र किया, रम्मान एक नृत्यशैली है जो कि यूनेस्को ने जो है जिसको जो है पांडव नृत्य जो है, पांडव नृत्य तो नहीं कहूंगा, पांडव नृत्य भी है एक शैली, लेकिन रम्मान को स्पेशली यूनेस्को ने जो है वो वर्ल्ड हेरिटेज घोषित किया, विश्व विरासत घोषित किया, इट हैज बीन डिक्लेयर्ड एज अ वर्ल्ड हेरिटेज. सो द पीपल हु आर वर्किंग हियर ऑन दोज टॉपिक्स often get unnoticed, often don't get the citation, but it doesn't mean that the importance of their research work is not there. It is important because they are novel, they are doing their own work, they are contributing a lot in that particular field.
Okay. Asim Alik, sir, can you please suggest me about the social science journals? You are talking only about science. Here many students are from social science.
Yeah. Yes. Sir, what you do? For social sciences, we were discussing the web of science only. And social science, you go to the web of science website. You go to the Scopus website. Okay, subject specific listing is there on the basis of even in the elsewhere, the publisher. I have not uttered a single journal's name so far. I have just mentioned the publisher's name. These publishers are not science publishers. Please understand. Elsewhere, Springer, Bentham, Taylor and Francis, and so many publishers. You go there, subject specific, you will get the list of journals which are for social sciences. Now it's on up to you how to get up to that level to publish your work.
One suggestion for the social science scholars, that please go through the project MOOS by John Hopkins University. It's database service provided by John Hopkins University in the field of social science research, and you should go through this, and there will be you find your required information regarding the high impact factor journals. Okay. Project MOOS by John Hopkins University.
I-10 index we have discussed. Please go through the modules once again. However, I will give you a brief overview. H-index means number of papers published at least that much number of times or more. If I am having 10 having H-index 10, it means that each of my 10 papers are cited 10 or more times. Okay, so this is the credibility. This is the you can say benchmark of credibility of a researcher, and it increases only. Second thing is I-10 index. I-10 index is the Google Scholar Propriety Index. It provides that how many papers are there which are having 10 citations. How is it so?
Yes.
Yeah. So I-10 index, so you can have, and I-10 index is always greater than the H-index generally. Okay. And it is shown in your Google Scholar profile.
Most of the committee is coming from for making audits in academic institution. They are asking about whether your research published journals in UGC list or not. On which basis they have to publish papers? I don't understand this question.
Okay, committees. Boss, I'm saying that many committee members, sorry to say to seniors also, many of the senior people who are there in committee many times, in scrutinizing committee and all, don't have any idea about these things. So what to do? That go with the standards. Don't go with a condition in which you have to give the alibi of those things. No, it's okay. When I'm talking about a standard thing, you need not to give the alibis. So go with the standard things. This is the best solution. Otherwise, you will waste your time in giving the alibis and the supporting documents are my journal is good, it is okay. Okay.
Patentability. How to
identify the work is patented.
Boss,
patented or patentable?
Patentable.
It's like patented. No, the question is about patented.
doing it, getting the that
no,
two
things. This
maybe
is
he wanted to ask actually
already
how
patented
to check the
potential of
patent.
Okay, for that you have to do a good literature review. Whether it is novel or not, and what new thing can be done, whether it is in the realm of the patenting or not, you will have to focus on that particular. And that literature survey is different than the regular literature survey. You will have to have the literature review of patented also, patents also. Previous patents on that particular field, you will have to also literature. We couldn't, due to lack of time, we won't be able to cover each and everything in the course. But I would like to add that you must include, even in the sciences people and the applied sciences, you must do the patent survey. And your segment of a paper, segment of a chapter of literature review or literature survey must have the patent search. You must have at least 1-2 pages about the patents. Then only then you will be able to note what is the novelty in your work and whether it is patentable or not. Okay.
Why indigenous science journals are not reputed and not even considered by Indian scientists for their works? Very good question, sir.
Sir, indigenous journals for
like
many problems.
Current science.
Because current science is very, you know, current science is having the impact factor. I think it's 0.2, 0.3.
Not that much reputation. And not even considered by Indian scientists for their work. It is true, sir.
It is true. What happens that actually when I am getting a fund, I would like to get my paper published in as much as higher impact factor. Okay, so that's why I give the least priority to for my best work to the Indian journals or indigenous journals. This is the policy as a researcher, a person says. What is happening, and that too, secondly, current science is a very, very broad, has having very broad coverage. Okay, that's why. If I'm from a pharmaceutical science, a person is from social sciences, what will even a single, though it is fortnightly journal, it is fortnightly or weekly? Fortnightly.
Fortnightly
journal. It is having a very good number of papers. But if I'll spend my time to search a particular topic of my interest, of my field, I would hardly get even a single paper sometime. So what is happening? Even the readers are not going seeing to the, those things. Current science. I don't think so. Okay, in my field, in the last 10 years, hardly 10 paper won't be there in the current science. I can guarantee you this thing. So this is a problem because the reader is not reading it. I am not. I haven't gone through the current science even a single issue thoroughly. Just if it came across when I'm searching something, then I go toward a particular journal. Say for example, in very first module, very first week, we discussed that professor, SP University Pune's professor's article regarding the predatory journals, which was in the current science. So I came across that thing, that's why I referred that thing. That's the basic problem.
Another question is, sir,
when applying for API, which period impact factor is considered? First year?
No, the year of published or current impact factor?
Impact factors.
Current impact factor is considered or the year of publication?
Basically, it should be considered. Current. It is that current, not current.
No.
That when it is first published. Okay, because it may vary. It may vary. It doesn't mean when it was published, you can mention there, or you can, if it is increased, you put there. However, it there is no clarity regarding this thing in anything.
But it will be very difficult to get the impact factor of that year.
Year. It's better if it is increased. Generally, people put the higher one.
Increase.
In generally. I have seen many journals which are reputed one, which only, if their impact
or
factor
you can
decrease,
choose which
they
is
mention.
Beneficial for you.
Generally, these people do like this only.
One question is, how to suggest experts for review? Review, if we have submitted a paper.
First thing, it should not be associated with you for last 4-5 years. He or she should not be your supervisor. Third thing, it's better to have an unbiased person. Okay. Thirdly, next point is many journals ask for the proposed reviewers and the disagreed reviewer. What is they call non-proposed reviewers?
Non-proposed.
You can pinpoint the persons from that particular field in that you don't want the review to be sent to those people also. So it's better to. However, it doesn't mean editor sends on its own databases. They are just increasing the databases by your reviews. It hardly, a matter of fact, a hardly an editor gives the same reviewer, you know, proposed by the author. बस केवल ये ऐसा आप दिल के खुश रखने को गाली पे ख्याल बेहतर है कि आपने कर दिया तो ठीक है. हाँ कई बार ऐसा होता है कि अगर आ गया, अगर वो रिव्यू वापस आ गया आपके पास, रिव्यूअर के पास ही आ गया, तो जनरली वही वो लोग करते हैं जो जर्नल, जो जिनका रिव्यू का लेवल, जिन लेवल जर्नल्स का लेवल कम होता है, जिनके पास डेटा बैंक नहीं होता है. दो जर्नल्स विच आर नॉट हैविंग द डेटा बैंक ऑफ द रिव्यूअर्स, एक्सपर्ट रिव्यूअर्स, दे सेंड द सेम पर्सन टू दो रिव्यूअर्स एंड दिस इज अ बिग क्वेश्चन मार्क रादर.
Please repeat the conditions of referring experts slowly.
Yeah, number one, it should not be, the he or she should not be affiliated to you, your work, or not be co-author with you for last 4 to 5 years at least.
No direct relation should be there.
Okay. Secondly, he or she should not be from your supervisor, mentor, or team member. Thirdly, he or she should not be from your same institution. Okay. And next thing is that what I was saying, एक और हमने डिस्कस किया था कि वो जो है, हाँ आप ये भी कर सकते हैं कि नॉन, जिसको those which are your very good well wishers on in your field, to whom you want that your review must not be there with them, you can also propose the reviewers you think that your manuscript should not go to those people. So not only propose, you can also propose the names to whom your manuscript should not go.
Sir, what's the white paper?
White paper of what?
No, white paper. The type of paper. White paper.
White paper with respect to the... white paper is the claiming the... each and everything.
How to write white paper and publish them?
White paper, I think... Sorry, in which field you are talking about? White paper is a legal language, or you can say in the constitutional language, in which when we put... white paper means when we put the actual condition of a particular thing or particular area is called white paper. When the things are concealed and the people are asking that you should come up with the white paper. White paper means each thing should be clarified in detail, the current thing. That is the white paper.
One person asking how to differentiate between national and international journals. And is there any criteria? In fact, I see journals white stating paper international is, are not truly international.
Sir, white paper is more type of an authoritative report. Authoritative report.
The same thing. Yes.
In most of the cases, it is given by the government.
Government. Yeah, I'm saying that the census ka data. Yes. The census, the data of census is there.
How to write them?
You cannot write, I think.
No, he can write if he is associated with any NGO working on any specific issue.
If you are the admin, then you can write the white paper. You are the authority to produce the white paper. I cannot do the data mining and presented white paper. It would be meta-analysis. It can't be a white paper. Okay?
Shodh Ganga.
It will be covered in our next module.
We are coming with these modules in coming week. Okay, sir. Common publishing legal issues and how.
One question is, sir, there.
Funding agencies. Balasini. One person is asking about the funding agencies. How to find the suitable funding agencies.
And another question. Yes, we will cover it. And he was also asking about the thesis writing. So we will cover. We will cover these two topics and have some patience. Okay.
Referred and peer-reviewed journal. What is the difference between referred journal and peer-reviewed?
And
journal?
One more issue was there. How to differentiate national and international journals?
National journals means which are national publishers in which they are being published from your own country only. If they are published from abroad, it is international journal. By just naming international, it doesn't mean that it becomes an international journal. Always remember this thing. This is the fact. Okay, you cannot say that I am running a journal from International Journal of Pharmacy from Srinagar Gadwal. It doesn't mean that it becomes an international.
So, but when we are talking about impact factor or and other these type of matrices, It doesn't matter how
it doesn't matter how where it belongs. Doesn't matter the name, national or international. Yeah. If a journalist is not having neither national or nor international in that name, what will happen? Won't you consider that
nature?
Name?
Nature.
Simple name, current science, okay? In the national perspective.
Yes.
So it doesn't mean whether you write the Indian or national or international.
Asian.
It is the indexing. Yes. It is the impact factor which counts.
That
okay?
matters most.
That matters.
How is the author matrix calculated for second, third, fourth and succeeding authors? Author matrices? For second, third and so
author matrix doesn't discriminate between first, second or corresponding author. Okay?
Specifically if, author matrix.
For author matrix, it doesn't discriminate between being and first, second or third. It doesn't matter at all. Okay?
What is the value of the first and corresponding author? Equal?
We have discussed it.
What weightage? What weightage is given?
For first?
First and corresponding
author. Same weightage is there for first and corresponding author.
Yes.
Okay? Please. Generally, it is the practice that you make the first author your research scholar. The research scholar or the person who is doing the doing the research, who has executed it in the lab, okay, should be the first author. And corresponding author should be, in general, the senior author, supervisor or mentor. It is the standard practice. Rest, I don't want to comment the things what the people are practicing.
How do we know the impact factor of a journal published by the regional languages like Kannada and Telugu? Okay, you just go to the list, go through the list, JCR list, Journal Citation Report 2019 by Thomson Reuters, and search for the journal name. If it is there, and there should be an impact factor for that journal. Okay? Sir, I published a chapter in edited book, but these...
Deepika.
They made spelling mistakes in the heading only. When I checked my manuscript, the spelling was correct. What can I do? Published paper, sir.
You can't do anything when it's published.
You can only retract.
You can only retract. Okay. Once it is published, you can't do.
Officially withdraw that.
Actually, the kind of publisher you have chosen. Sorry to say. You should not go with those kind of publishers. I am working with some of the reputed publishers of the country. When I had written a book on essentials of pharmaceutical technology. We have written, Dr. Mona and me. So we spent complete 1 year for writing the things, each and everything done. Then what it did? Then my book was sent for the peer review. The comment was sent to me. Then I again revised. Then it was again sent for the revision. It took 7 to 8 months. Then Mr. Shah is there, so in Hyderabad. So he called me, Dr. Simalji, can you come here? I go, oh. So then what he did, he gave me his hotel's room. And for 7 days, I was sitting with the people. And I was correcting the things there only. And then finalize the thing. This is the way actually the publisher works. It is the responsibility of the publisher. If the publisher is not seeing and just asking for making the money, if it is doing, then obviously this kind of silly things will come. So please select a good publisher. Select a good journal. Okay?
Sir,
Registry Journalist does not have many top journals. Can something be done about it?
Yeah, of course. You can't. Top journals.
How come it is possible that top journals?
No. It might be possible.
Anything is possible.
Yes. So anything is possible because. I'm telling you, the people who are sitting
still
there,
dynamic,
it's dynamic. You raise the issue through your institution, it will be included. And obviously, I have told you that UGC has clearly mentioned if it is indexed in Scopus and Web of Science, 100%, it will be considered as a indexed one. It will be considered as an approved one. Only in the cases where it is not indexed in Scopus and Web of Science, you will have to represent. And top journals in which terms? Because the persons who are sitting there, they have got 40 years, 30 years, 50 years, 40 years experience. Generally 30 to 40 years experience people are sitting there. At that time when they were doing the research, these things were not there. They are not much aware. Okay? You are more aware about those things. You will have to put the things in their knowledge. They will certainly agree with you. Okay?
Next question is, sir, how your previous papers, publications matter for your career in research and development, specifically in clinical trials? If
what do you want to convey?
Specifically, so you have to consider that the, your previous work should be in the relevant field.
It should be in relevant field, and obviously, however, the count numbers are going to be with you, yes. Obviously. Secondly, if it is a related work, then you will get the fundings. Okay. As for the funding agency, question was there that how to go get that thing, the good funding agency. We are going to come up with a module also. However, it won't be possible. Our single module is very less regarding that. But we will be discussing those things with the people in a particular seminar also.
Sir, another question is here. The reputed publishers ask the author to get permission for citations. I want to know, does it necessary to get permission for all the citations?
No, not for citation. Yes, if you are plagiarizing the thing, then you need the permission. Otherwise, for citing, you don't need permission. Doesn't require permission.
Yes.
And how to seek permission from copyright? Permission, copyright. No, permission, copyright is to be taken from the publisher. They have the permission section also. Every reputed publisher has a special section regarding this, regarding permissions. You go to the any reputed publisher. Either if you are not getting any particular section, you just write to the editor that you want the permission. Okay.
Shweta Jain was asking how to add our papers in Google Scholar if we don't have any paper online.
You can add manually.
Yes.
There is an option, but for that you will have to activate your profile. Okay. Then only you can add on it manually.
One more thing you can do, you can go to ResearchGate and you can upload your details there, and then it will be transferred to the Google Scholar, because most of the things uploaded, most of the papers, articles uploaded in the ResearchGate, they will be uploaded or shared with the Google Scholar.
Is it best to request, huh? Reference papers from the publisher?
Publisher से मांगे paper की author से मांगे?
Author.
देखिए साहब, publisher तो
देने publisher will not give you
publisher
the paper.
Publisher won't give you. It's better. It's better to go ask from the author.
Yeah. So one question was there. How to retract any submitted paper?
Yeah, you can just write to your editor, to the editor of the journal, with the condition and with the clarifying the things, you can retract the paper in the publisher, if publisher allows you. However, it's a typical thing to get the paper retracted.
Can I withdraw a research paper after acceptance?
Generally, it is very tough. You can withdraw if it is not published.
By writing to the publisher.
By writing, you can say you don't want to get it published. You can withdraw it. No issue.
And please define relevant field in commerce area. Commerce, business, management, and commerce.
You can go to the any field, accounting, you can go all the sections you
the
are having.
The subfields of
what
this
are the
main
subjects
field.
You are having, you can go through these. Yes. Okay? Even the, you can have the interdisciplinary approach in the, maybe in sciences, social sciences also.
Whether the chapter published in non-ISSN, ISBN considered for direct recruitment?
No.
Without ISSN?
No.
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 Can you please discuss with the example, so what? What are the particular things for which an author needs permission? ये हमने किया है जिक्र कि जो publisher के जो whatever अगर plagiarism का scene आपके पास आता है, कोई copying की बात आती है, then you need the permission. Otherwise you don't need the permission.
Yes. If you are using any author's content as it is, as such, then you need permission. If you are going to write it in your own way, you don't need permission. Yet you need to cite. Okay.
Nutrition mein good national and international journals.
Again, just go with these journal citation
report. Elsewhere ke bahut acche journal hai. International nutrition mein hai. I think uska jo impact factor hai, as far as remember, 3 ya 4 ke beech mein impact factor hai. Elsewhere ka jo paper hai nutrition pe jo hai. So many
the
good
actual journals. Data they will get at the JCR. Report.
Go to the publisher. Go to the JCR. Okay. Make it a habit
to go with the JCR time to time, okay? Can we upload our article published in a hard copy in a journal to ResearchGate without taking permission from editors if then if yes, no, how to upload? You can just upload the details and abstract, not the full paper. You have to take permission from the publisher.
Until it is open access. If it is already
publisher,
open access.
If you have signed a copyright agreement. If not, you can upload it. Okay. Sir, what is the difference between NAS rating and impact factor? And which is the best? NAS rating and impact factor.
NAS rating,
impact
sorry.
Factor,
impact factor is
best.
The best criteria till date, globally accepted. You don't have to worry much about the impact factor if you got few papers with good impact factors.
Ethical okay. permission is compulsory for carrying on study in human. Yes, of course.
Yes, yes.
I'm taking blood samples from subjects.
No. You require the permission. Don't do the things without permission. You must have ethic. And
human,
that, for human trials, it is not just institutional ethical review committee. Yes. It is ICMR approved.
Yes,
it is not
yes.
animal ethical committee, CPSCA. No, it is required from the ICMR committee is different. Always remember, there are two kinds of committees. Animal ethical committee and manual committees. That man, the human trial committees. ICMR approval. Don't do these kind of things. You will be in trouble. Even if you have done a wonderful research.
Chandrika, listen.
Without this permission, don't do this thing. And if you have done this thing, keep silence. You cannot mention in your thesis you can without permission.
First try to get the permission and then you can carry on your word. Anjana Arun is asking
about...
She is repeating the question. What to include in expected outcome of a research proposal? Expected outcome...
Why you are doing this? Expected outcome is
research
simply...
Research proposal mein maybe
yes.
she wants to
why she
that.
Is going to do that research? That will be her research outcome, na?
एक्सपेक्टेड आउटकम आपका जो ऑब्जेक्टिव है वो आप जो उसको आपको आगे उसका जो फ्यूचर पर्सपेक्टिव सामने रखोगे वही एक्सपेक्टेड आउटकम है आपका है ना मतलब आपका आप वन स्टेप अहेड क्या सोच रहे हैं वो आपको वहां लिखना है एज एक्सपेक्टेड आउटकम ठीक है
So I'm doing research based on a pilot study. Sometimes I need to refer more than 10% of the content in my dissertation. Will it be considered as plagiarism? Is there any alternative option? Yes, you have to write it in your own way. More than 10%, yes, it will be considered as plagiarism. Mm. You have to cite and write it in your own way first.
Mm. Bala asked, the, sir, what do you mean by the term conference proceeding? Conference proceeding are just the paper, you have presented the paper in the conference and it has been published as a full paper in the proceedings,
yes.
then the conference proceeding is equivalent to a one paper, okay? Yes. Otherwise not. Otherwise, you can just... it will be considered just a conference paper, not counted as a conference proceeding, which is equivalent to a one paper. Okay.
Do quality journal have their own plagiarism detection system, or
course.
Do they expect any other plagiarism detection site reports? No, they don't have their own plagiarism detection software, but they use the plagiarism detection software provided by the reputed agencies like Turnitin or Authenticate or Crossref. Okay. Is there any punishment for communicating same research paper in different journals with common indexing? Kindly reply yes.
It's plagiarism. It's plagiarism simply. If you are splitting the same paper, or even the same paper is sent to the two or more journals, then it's a problem. If it is by, it may be sometimes, I don't know how, sometimes if it is, it has happened, what should you do? You should withdraw one paper at least. If agar a galti ho gayi hai kisi karan se, कोई चीज ऐसा हो गया कि आप भूल गए विड्रॉ करना भूल गए चाहे डाला आपने कायदे में दो पेपर तो आपको साथ में पैरेलल में कभी डालना ही नहीं चाहिए ठीक है डल गया है वो हो गया तो अगर आपने रिट्रैक्ट हुआ नहीं हुआ तो कम से कम उन दोनों पेपर को एक साथ अपने सीवी में तो मत रखिए एक ही पेपर को शो कीजिए डोंट शो द टू पेपर्स बोथ द पेपर्स ओके इन योर सीवी
वन क्वेश्चन इज हियर in an activity, we are asked to submit an article of 800 to 1000 words. Sir, will our mistakes be highlighted in the same so that we can learn from our mistakes?
So actually, it's a very concise text. 800 by our aim is that whether you are able to write a unique and original text and whether you are able to use the plagiarism detection software and generate a report. This is the actual outcome. So what we can do, however, we can spare some time with some 1, 2, 3 good papers or some washed papers or some papers which are having some unique problems. We may discuss in some webinar or some issue or some report we may release sometimes, because it is, I think, 15th of September is the last date, and we will discuss it at that time only, after that only.
Deepika Mishra asking, there are no assignments till now in this course. I am missing the assignments, or it has
It's a weekly assignment. Weekly assignment, the graded quiz. Every week we are having the quiz, which is an assignment. Okay, yes. It is a weekly assignment. Apart from that, a single assignment has already, that subjective assignment, which 800 to 1000 word writing and plagiarism detection we have given. Please go through the course. We have given 5 weeks, 5 weekly quiz. They are graded assignments plus one subjective assignment we have given. Okay, please go through this code dashboard. Okay.
Sir, how Chandrika, to approach
in
ICMR?
In relation to that question, she is asking related to how the human to approach ICMR for getting ethical permission. My university don't have human ethical committee and don't go.
Your for university has to constitute a committee. You cannot go individually to ICMR. Okay.
Sir, one thing I want to ask her, that from where she get subjects for that study?
Personal request. Nobody will agree to that point, no?
To take blood samples and to analyze.
Yeah, it is not at all permissible. What you can do, you should not do. Rather, if you are unable to get a committee during the time, I better suggest you to change your topic rather.
So, she can collaborate with any medical college and then she can...
Or you can collaborate with some people that will be who are having those ICMR committees in your nearby institutes, and then get your proposal, get your research methodology, get your
clinical trials,
your trial protocols. The protocols, get your protocols approved, and then use it. Okay, you can do that thing, but your protocol must be approved from some legal agency. Yes, yes, yes. Okay.
In most of the cases, most of the medical colleges have these facilities. I think she could collaborate.
And you have the time. आप कभी भी अपना quiz जमा कीजिए, ठीक है?
Manish Mishra, for graded quiz marks are not being yet displayed.
marks will be displayed. What is the last date? 31st October. And the marks will be displayed only after that. Okay. Generally, I will like to let you know the marks range is from 75% to 83%. What I have seen recently, generally 75% से लेके 83% तक का जो है एवरेज है जो लोगों का है.
सर, कैन इन द एब्स्ट्रैक्ट पब्लिश इन द कॉन्फ्रेंस प्रोसीडिंग सिलेक्टेड फॉर पोस्टर प्रेजेंटेशन काउंटेड एज पब्लिश्ड पेपर?
नहीं, पोस्टर
नॉट ओनली द एब्स्ट्रैक्ट.
अगर वो खाली एब्स्ट्रैक्ट के फॉर्म में है भैया, तो काउंट नहीं होगा पेपर के फॉर्म.
इट शुड बी अ फुल पेपर
तभी वो काउंट होगा. इट विल बी काउंटेड ओनली व्हेन इट इज इन ए फुल फॉर्म पेपर, तभी वो, नहीं तो नहीं होगा वो. अगर आपने वो किया तो आप कॉन्फ्रेंस में दिखा दीजिए और फुल पेपर पेपर में लिखाइए, तो वो सेम पेपर यू कैन पब्लिश. अगर वो केवल एब्स्ट्रैक्ट के फॉर्म में वहां हुआ है एक्सेप्ट और पब्लिश हुआ है, तो देन यू कैन पब्लिश. ओके, सो
हाउ कैन आई कंफर्म इफ आई रजिस्टर्ड फॉर दिस एकेडमिक राइटिंग कोर्स एंड आल्सो रजिस्टर्ड फॉर द एग्जाम? नो वन इज रजिस्टर्ड फॉर एग्जाम येट, एंड टू चेक इफ यू आर रजिस्टर्ड फॉर दिस कोर्स, जस्ट गो टू द स्वयं वेबसाइट, लॉग इन विद योर क्रेडेंशियल्स, एंड इफ यू गेट a list of course and academic writing written on there.
If you are getting the email from us, you are registered. And please remember, अगर आप बाद में भी कर रहे हैं तो आपके पास वो सारे मॉड्यूल अवेलेबल है. और साथ में हम ये बात कर रहे थे कि आप अपने मोबाइल से डाउनलोड कर लीजिए. यूट्यूब में जैसे वीडियो डाउनलोड होते हैं, ऑफलाइन उन्हें देखते रहिए.
You can submit all the graded assignments all together before 31st October.
This is the beauty. So we know that the
MOOCs, I have missed few graded assignments, what will happen? There is nothing like that. You can submit all together if you have missed it.
Yeah. And we know that the MOOCs are the, you are not, it is not the first priority of, otherwise you would have considered it for regular courses. आप अपनी फुर्सत में कर रहे हैं चीजों को, अच्छे से कीजिए. और उसको कोई बात नहीं, आज नहीं कल कर लीजिएगा, पर आपको लास्ट डेट से पहले करना है, ये ध्यान रखिए.
31st October is the last.
Sir, one question is there.
Please submit all the assignments.
Consideration of foreign PhD. Consideration of foreign PhD in India.
Yeah, AIU, Association of Indian Universities का काम ही यही है कि वो जो है कौन सी यूनिवर्सिटी की कौन सी डिग्री वो मान्य है कि नहीं है, वो एट पार है कि नहीं है, whether it is at par or not, it is decided by the AIU. You go to the website of AIU, Association of Indian Universities. उसका काम ही यही है इस तरह की जो है मान्यता और एड पार जो है घोषित करना, वो वहां पर उसकी लिस्टिंग आपको पूरी की पूरी मिलेगी उसकी वेबसाइट में, ठीक है।
आशीष कुमार, अगेन वी हैव आंसर्ड दिस क्वेश्चन अर्लियर, इफ आई हैव पब्लिश पेपर प्रीवियसली व्हाट इंपैक्ट फैक्टर शुड आई मेंशन, करंट और प्रीवियस वन?
If you can find the impact factor of that time of publication, you should mention that. If you cannot, then go with the current.
जनरली आपको करंट ही देखना चाहिए, इन जनरल देखिए बेहतर ये होगा ताकि करंट ही देखना चाहिए, क्योंकि कोई जहाँ बढ़ रहा है वहां तो आप क्रेडिट लेंगे और जहाँ घट रहा है वहां क्रेडिट नहीं लेंगे, तो ऐसा नहीं चलेगा ना। तो बेस्ट रहता है कि आपको एक ही तरह का क्राइटेरिया रखना चाहिए, ठीक है ना, क्योंकि जो भी बंदा होगा वो करंट आपका इम्पैक्ट फैक्टर देखेगा ना, पुराना नहीं देखेगा। हाँ रख सकते हो आप, करते हैं लोग, आपको नहीं मिल रहा है तो आप पुराना रख लो, वही लोकेशन नहीं बोल रहा है कि अगर आपको नहीं मिल रहा है तो आप पुराना ही लिख लीजिए, कोई बात, क्योंकि उसका हिस्ट्री में कहीं
जो
तो
रहा है, मिल रहा है वो,
जो मिल रहा है आपको, जो मिल रहा है वो रख लीजिए आप, और बेटर है अपडेटेड रख सके तो अच्छी बात है।
सर आई एम अनअवेलेबल ऑन एग्जाम डेट 9th नवंबर, कैन आई गेट एग्जाम लेटर व्हेन यू अगेन रीस्टार्ट द कोर्स एंड टेक टाइम?
Yes, generally, हम recycle, दूसरी साइकिल में होगा ये, नाइन्थ को आप दे, नहीं दे पाएंगे तो सॉरी, क्योंकि हमारे पास एक ही स्लॉट है यहाँ पर पूरा। और आप लोगों की सुविधा के लिए मैंने जो है इसको जो है पेन पेपर से इसको सीबीटी पे लाया, कंप्यूटर बेस्ड टेस्ट पे लेके आए हम, ताकि केवल ऑब्जेक्टिव टाइप रहे। मेरा मकसद, हमारी टीम का मकसद ये है कि आप इस चीज को जाने। देखिए कोई ऐसा तो नहीं है कि आपने जो है 15 वीक पढ़ के या कुछ चंद मॉड्यूल पढ़ के आप एकेडमिक राइटर बन जाएंगे यार, मैं आपको एकेडमिक राइटर बना दूंगा। इट इज नॉट लाइक दैट, इट इज अबाउट द प्रैक्टिस। मैं दोबारा इस बात को कह रहा हूँ, मेरा वादा है कि आई विल ट्रिगर ए गुड एकेडमिक राइटर इन यू, हमारा वादा है, लेकिन आपको प्रैक्टिस खुद करनी पड़ेगी। एग्जाम, ऑल दीज थिंग्स डजंट मैटर, एक्चुअली द थिंग मैटर इज यू विल बी एबल टू राइट इन योर ओन लैंग्वेज, इन द रीडर फ्रेंडली लैंग्वेज, इन द कन्विंसिंग लैंग्वेज, इन ए, एंड यू कैन प्रोड्यूस क्वालिटी राइटिंग, दैट इज द एम ऑफ आवर कोर्स। सो इट डजंट मैटर अगर आप नहीं कर पाती है 9 तारीख के आसपास का, हम देखेंगे कोई ऐसा इश्यू होता है, वैसे ऐसा हमें जानकारी नहीं है, क्योंकि ये भी मेरा जो है हम लोगों का जो है, हम पहली बार इसको स्वयं के पोर्टल पे लेके आ रहे हैं, तो मोस्ट प्रॉब्ली दूसरी साइकिल में जब होगा तो देन यू कैन, पर उसके लिए आपको पुनः प्रक्रिया से गुजरना पड़ेगा। ये के जो क्विज वगैरह हैं वो सारे काउंट नहीं होते हैं, ये मैं आपको बताना चाहूँगा, आपको वहाँ फिर से काउंट करना पड़ेगा चीज़ों को। पर आपके लिए वो चीज़ें ईजी होंगी, क्योंकि ऐसा तो नहीं होने वाला है कि मैं सारे क्वेश्चन वापस चेंज करूँगा, एवरीथिंग इज गोइंग टू बी ऑलमोस्ट सेम। ओके
सुरभि पवार, some journals have shown impact factor as 2018 and 2019. What does that mean? Is it off for year 2018 or 19?
One year impact factor for 2 years or 1 year?
एक ही कहता है, 2 साल में आता है, पर देखिए साहब, अगर 2019 में जो journal का impact factor release हो रहा है ना, वो 2019 का नहीं होता, वो 2018 का होता है, ठीक है ना, ये था। तो इसीलिए बोला कि 2019 जुलाई में जो journal का impact factor आया है, वो release जुलाई में हुआ है, लेकिन वो impact factor कब का है? 2018 का है। समझे आप बात को, इस बात को समझिए चीज में, हम अक्सर इसे कंफ्यूज होते हैं, इसीलिए वो 2018/2019 रखा गया, लिखा गया।
I suggest you always cross-check the impact factor suggested by the publisher with the list JCR, Journal Citation Report. Okay? Always cross-check it. Okay? Does this course is useful for CAS?
We got my thing, na.
Sir, does this course is useful for CAS?
Boss, CAS certification as a refresher, ये refresher course नहीं है, हम पहले भी clear कर चुके हैं report में, ठीक है? CAS के लिए इसलिए आपके लिए useful है, मैं आपको बार बार ये कह रहा हूँ, आप course, इस course की जो मंशा है हमारी, मकसद है, जो चीज़ों को अगर आप ढंग से ले लेंगे ना, तो आपको मैं वादा कर रहा हूँ, आपको CAS में इसका API कितना होता है, उसका API कितना होता है, ये पूछने की जरूरत नहीं पड़ेगी। You will be able to produce the quality article in the impact factor journals. You will be able to write book. You will be able to write the conference paper. You will be able to write the research proposals. You will be able to write the OERs and develop the MOOCs like this in the list. So we will be covering those kind of things which are, I would like to say, paras patthar ki tarah. Hum aapko aisa banana cha rahe hain ki kam se kam aapko wo cheez ke, aapko uske advantage bahut sare milenge. Theek hai? So don't think about that. अगर सी एस के लिए कर रहे हैं, सॉरी, केवल यही मकसद है आपका, तो आई वुड रिक्वेस्ट यू गो टू द अर्पित कोर्सेज एंड डू द थिंग्स देयर। ओके
सर, व्हाट इज बेटर, पब्लिशिंग अ पेपर इन कॉन्फ्रेंस प्रोसीडिंग और इन अ जर्नल ऑफ अवर चॉइस?
ऑब्वियसली जर्नल करना चाहिए आपको,
इफ यू अगर आर गेटिंग अ गुड इंपैक्ट फैक्टर,
आपको रीडरशिप नहीं मिलेगी कॉन्फ्रेंस की प्रोसीडिंग की, आपको अगर वो अच्छे जर्नल में भी छप रहा है, जो नहीं छपता है, जनरली कॉन्फ्रेंस प्रोसीडिंग्स आर नॉट देयर इन दी गुड जर्नल्स, they are not published in good journals in 90% cases, except with exceptions, some exceptions. So it's better that you get your work published in good indexed and good impact factor journals.
Kashmir,
it is always better.
Kashmir students, they are not able to submit
that. I was going to answer that. Asim Ali, you can just submit your assignments till the date of end of this course. Yes, sir. Okay, take your time.
Internet
is not available.
Internet is available. No issue. No issue. Asim, Kashmir students can. Yes. It's not.
You have time. Kept. You have
31st October तक हमने weekly assignment का time वैसे भी रखा है last week तक का. हाँ, जो subject assignment है, उसके लिए date जो है, that date is 15th of September. वो इसलिए रखा है क्योंकि उसको evaluate करने का time भी चाहिए.
That time, the situation will resolve.
नहीं होगा. We will take care of this thing. You write to us. You write to us. Okay. You write us. We will take care of this thing. And
sir, time.
We have got to the limit. Okay.
Yes.
So, boss, ऐसा है. आज के लिए इतना ही. काफी कुछ हमने कुछ साथ most of the questions we have covered today.
So, my last question will cover. What is the difference between the article processing charges and paid journal? Are paid journals not?
What is the difference between article processing charges and paid journal?
देखिए article processing charge तो ये भी हो सकता है बहुत अच्छा journal जो है कौन बोल रहा है हिंदी में comfortable हैं भाई आप लोग Sam Khan
हाँ
so Khan साहब ऐसा है कि अगर आप जो है article processing charge देना कोई गलत नहीं है provided वो अच्छा journal है भाई index journal कई अच्छे journal जो है जिनमें जो time लगाते हैं जो 7 month, 6 month इनका review में लगता है वो कहते हैं हम आप process fast processing charge दीजिए fast track mode दीजिए मैं पैसा दीजिए पर उनका decision उससे affect नहीं होता है कि आप पैसे लेते हैं कि नहीं ले रहे journal वो खराब है जिन्होंने कहा कि जी पैसे हम ले रहे हैं और इसका मतलब done है कि आपका छपना ही छपना ठीक है ये वो जो टाइम बताए जो प्रोसेसिंग चार्ज इज ए डिफरेंट थिंग और पब्लिशिंग चार्ज समटाइम्स यू विल आई एम बी कॉशियस APC article processing charge is different and article publishing charge is different. Sometimes you see that okay article processing charge is only $50 or $20 or maybe 200 rupees. वो है आपने वो दिया और उसके बाद जब वो छपा उसने कहा जी अब मुझे $500 दीजिए वो तो processing charge था अब आपका हो जाए publishing charge. So मैंने इसको कहा है पहले भी. I have also mentioned in our module that you please see the total charging by the journal. वो कैसे ले रहा है how it is charging you page wise some figure wise article processing charge article publishing charge so be cautious okay
is it compulsory to write guide's name in publication
yes
yes
it is ethical
it's ethical you can't avoid
you should not avoid
you avoid it the academic people will avoid you
yes
okay where you are you have gone to you know you have come to interview to me okay say for example I will not talk about anything I will say what you have done in your work so you will say that this
Arun,
is my work
Arun
say this is my work I will say who was your supervisor you will name him or her I will say where is the name what was the problem there I don't want to listen it is not my domain but if there is no tuning between the supervisor and at least whether tuning is there or not he has been your supervisor his name must be there
and
the people don't like the HR people don't like the people who do this kind of thing okay they do this simply scrutinize your application
and whatever the research is or was the idea always belongs to two person but one researcher and another one is supervisor the idea always also belongs to the supervisor so you should
अच्छा एक मेरा निवेदन आप सब लोगों से अभी हमारे पास कम ही लोग बचे हैं वैसे पर मैं चाहूंगा कि आप सब लोग प्लीज अपना फेसबुक पेज को एक दिन हमारे कोर्स के लिए दीजिए क्योंकि 31 अगस्त तक जो है मुझे खत्म होने जा रहा है एनरोलमेंट बंद होने जा रहे हैं उसके बाद कोर्स में कोई एनरोल नहीं कर पाएगा तब कोर्स चलता रहेगा एक दिन हमें दीजिए एक दिन कोर्स की इन्फॉर्मेशन कोर्स का जो फ्लायर है हमारा उसको शेयर कीजिए उसकी इन्फॉर्मेशन को शेयर कीजिए एटलीस्ट वन डे इन फेसबुक ओके प्लीज आई थिंक At least this much I can expect from all my learners. We have already, for your kind information, we have already crossed 10K marks, more than 10,000 people. We are the family of 10,000 learners. So we would like to make it historical, okay?
10,003.
10,003, okay. Yeah, we are the family of 10,003, okay? So 10,003 plus. Okay.
Yes.
10,003. So please. So this has been a very good session, and it's a quite long session. The many people have joined us. Thanks for joining us from Team AW, and hope we will be answering your queries like this.